Hi, and welcome to my video about viewing instructor feedback in Canvas. This video is designed to help you understand the differences among a rubric, instructor comments, and instructor feedback. Unfortunately, many students, and yes, even those students who have used Canvas before, mistakenly believe that the rubric and comments in the assignment comments box are the instructor's feedback. However, that is not always the case. To understand the differences, we'll need to navigate away from the module view and into the gradebook. Here is an assignment called Learning About Rubrics. We can see by hovering over this icon that there are two comments associated with this assignment. If we click the icon, the comments will appear. Now, for the purposes of this video, I've added two comments just to show what they might look like. This first comment indicates the students probably earned a maximum points, or close to it, so I probably provided some additional information that I felt would be helpful for this particular student. The second comment indicates that the student did okay, but could improve some aspects of the work. And because in this course I allow one resubmission per assignment, this student could use my feedback to improve the work and his grade. Remember, the assignment comment box is used primarily to provide brief instructions or information specific about the assignment. It should not be used for general communication with the instructor. Instead, use the course inbox. Next, you can also view the rubric by clicking on this little icon. And the rubric is important because it provides valuable information about where a student did well and where the student needs to improve. However, it does not provide detailed and specific information that's tailored to the student. To actually see my feedback, you have to click on the assignment itself. And when the page loads, you want to look for the link up here that says View Feedback. It's in the top right side of the window. Click on this View Feedback link and then wait for the page to load. In this preview window, depending on the size of your screen, you may not be able to see the feedback yet. If you're using a tablet or smartphone, you may have to resize things to gain more real estate for viewing the document. First, click on this little icon to hide course navigation, this panel here. Next, expand the preview screen as much as possible. Move it up to the top left side of the screen, and then pull down the right corner, down and to the right as far as possible. Now, you should be able to scroll down until you see the yellow boxes with my feedback in them. On really small screens, if you cannot see the feedback, or can only see part of it, you may have to use the horizontal scroll bar to see all of the feedback. There are also two other ways that you can view feedback. First, you can use the minus or plus buttons. However, that may not work well on smaller screens, so another option is to use this nifty little download button on the toolbar. Click on the download button, and when the pop-up box appears, click on the Download Annotated PDF because this includes the actual feedback. When the PDF document opens, the first thing you want to do is gain more real estate by closing the right-hand panel. If you scroll down you'll see the same feedback boxes appear. That were in the Canvas preview window. However, if you hover your mouse over the feedback box, you'll notice that there is a yellow line that indicates which part of the document the feedback pertains to. Again, depending on your screen size, you might want to adjust the resolution until you can find the best fit for your situation. Also note that you can adjust the sizes of the feedback box. One major advantage to downloading the feedback is that you can place it next to your assignment and then refer to it while making corrections and improvements. You can also save the feedback document to your computer, which is handy if you need to stop working on an assignment. Saving it to your computer will also allow you to work offline if necessary. So now you know the difference among rubrics, comments, and instructor feedback. You also know how to access, view, and download that feedback, which means you are now ready to attempt the assignment, How to View Instructor Feedback. Good luck.